Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about transpiration. What is transpiration?
Transpiration is the loss of water vapor through the aerial parts of the leaf, especially the stomata, to the atmosphere. Transpiration pull is the upward movement of water from roots to the leaves due to transpiration.
So how does transpiration occur?
First, water leaves the xylem vessels in the leaf and forms a water film on the walls of the mesophyll cells through osmosis. This water film evaporates into the intercellular spaces, increasing the humidity of the air inside the leaf.
Thus, evaporation occurs at this point.
The water vapor diffuses down the concentration gradient from the inside of the leaf to the atmosphere through the stomata, and diffusion occurs at this point. This process of losing water through aerial parts of the plant is known as transpiration. Mesophyll cells that lose water would have a lower water potential, so osmosis takes place from the xylem into mesophyll cells. Collectively, the effect of drawing water by osmosis from xylem creates a force to transport water in the xylem called transpiration pull.
Now let's take a look at wilting.
Wilting occurs when the plant loses more water than it can absorb through its roots, meaning there is excessive water loss.
Due to the lack of water, the leaf cells lose their turgidity.
The leaf folds up to reduce exposure to sunlight, and this causes the guard cells to be unable to carry out photosynthesis, thus unable to produce energy or ATP to maintain turgidity. This causes the stomata to close such that less water is lost through transpiration. When the above occurs, it results in photosynthesis being compromised due to the lack of water. Lesser carbon dioxide diffusing since stomata is closed and lesser sunlight exposure as leaves are folded. Prolonged wilting can lead to death of plant. However, if wilting is not severe, the plant can be revived by supplying water to the plant.
Lastly, we will explore the four factors that affect transpiration. First is air movement or wind.
At higher wind speed, it means there is a higher rate at which water is removed from within vicinity of leaf.
This creates a steeper concentration gradient, thus a higher rate of transpiration. Second is temperature.
At higher temperature, there is higher rate of evaporation, thus a higher rate of transpiration.
Third is humidity. The smaller the amount of water vapor that is present in the atmosphere, meaning that there is a lower humidity. A steeper concentration gradient is created, and thus a higher rate of transpiration. Fourth, light intensity. At higher light intensity, the guard cells are more turgid due to higher rate of photosynthesis.
Thus, there is a larger opening of the stomata and a higher rate of transpiration.
That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.